Hi, this is Deborah with LegalOfficeGuru.com, and today I'm going to show you how to place a header in a letter. Putting a header into the second and subsequent pages of a letter is a multi-step process, but not unduly complicated. Here on this three-page letter, I'm going to start the way that all headers start. I could go over here to the Insert tab and click on Header, blank. That, however, inserts a type here box that I personally find a little annoying. My preferred method for starting a header is to simply double-click into the header area. Once I'm in the header, there's one thing I need to do right off to ensure that the header doesn't appear on the first page. Anytime my cursor is in the header and footer area, a contextual tab called Header and Footer Tools appears in the ribbon. This new tab I'm in at the moment gives me a number of choices for formatting my header, but the one I'm interested in right now is this checkbox called Different First Page. If I'm doing a second and subsequent page header for a letter, I want to make sure this box is checked. Once I check that box, you'll notice that something subtle has changed. This indicator here used to say simply Header. Now it says First Page Header. So now I know that if I type anything into this header, it will appear on the first page. Obviously, I want to type into the header that will appear starting on page 2. So to go directly to that header, I'm going to click on this Next button in the Header and Footer Tools Contextual tab, and it will take me directly to the next header, which starts on page 2. Now I can start typing information into this header. I'm going to put the recipient's name on the top line. To insert the date, I could simply type it in, but I'm going to use one of my favorite tricks. Because the drafting process for a particular letter could span over more than one day, I don't want to have to remember to go back and change the date. So on the second line, I insert the current date using the Date and Time button over here on the left. I pick the proper format. But before I hit OK, I'm going to check this box next to Update Automatically. That will ensure this letter always has today's date. Alternatively, and this is really my preference, I can put in a date field called Save Date that's available on the Insert tab under Quick Parts Fields. I choose the Save Date field under the Date and Time category, then go over here on the right and choose the correct format, then click OK. The difference between choosing the current Date and Time button on the Header and Footer Tools tab and this Save Date field is that while the former will always display the current date, the Save Date field will display the last date the document was saved. A subtle distinction, perhaps, but one that can become important in certain documents. Now that I've put in a self-calculating date, it's time to go down here to line 3 and put in the page number. I can type the word page and press the space bar, then go back to the Header and Footer Tools, go over here to page number, and choose Current Position, Plain Number. That will put in the current page number. If you want your page number line to say Page X of Y, you'll need to go back over to Quick Parts and insert another field called Num Pages. This is a field that calculates the total number of pages in the document. So I'll go over to the Insert tab, click on Quick Parts, then Field, and then using the Document Information category, I'm going to click on Num Pages, then choose this number format on the right before clicking OK. So we have all the information we need in the header. If you'd like to insert a separator line between this header and the rest of your document, the easiest way to do that is to simply use the underscore character on your keyboard. Once you're finished with your header, go back to Header and Footer Tools and click Close Header and Footer, and you're back in the text of your document. And you notice there is no header on this first page, but now there is on the second page. And that's how you create a letter header in any of the ribbon versions of Microsoft Word.